Misinformation in the house. Hello world, Misinformation here, coming to you live from the lands of the Ngunnawal and Ngambri people. Today I'm here at the Museum of the Australian Democracy. What actually is a referendum? How will it work? And will I get my democracy sausage?
It's the grease that keeps the gears of democracy turning.
It's the Australian way.
I'm here with Amy Lay, who is the Senior Curator at the Museum of Australian Democracy. So Amy, it feels like we've been hearing non-stop about this year's referendum, but a lot of people don't actually know what a referendum actually is. So how do they work?
Well, a referendum is actually really simple. A referendum is when the Australian public is asked if they would like to change the constitution. Like, that is the basic thing of it. We have the power to change it and the government is asking us if we want to.
For so many of us who have never voted in a referendum before, what is it going to be like?
You're going to head along to your polling station. You might pick up a democracy sausage or a lamington that's been made by a local parent at the primary school on your way in. You'll go in, you'll get your name checked off. You'll get handed the ballot and you'll get handed your pencil and in you'll go into the polling booth. You will be asked to say yes or no to the question.
And what happens if you don't write yes or no, or write something funny instead, like misinformation?
By far the best thing to do is only write yes or no if you agree or disagree with the change, and then save whatever funny thing you have to say for like your Twitter feed.
So Amy, on the day of voting, I'm at the hairdresser's, it's taking way too long, the purple dye, they have to go and get it from another shop. Do I have to go on the day? Is it compulsory?
It is compulsory to vote in a referendum. Just like in elections, you do need to go along and have your say. But there is early voting available too. There are certain places that you'll be able to go and pre-poll ahead of the day if you think that your hair appointment might run a little long.
Well, Amy, let's go and check out more of this fabulous exhibition.
Wonderful.
So Amy, tell me, how many successful referendums have we had?
It's actually not been that many. There's been 44 referendums that have been put to the Australian people in a total of 19 votes, but 8 is how many that have actually passed.
And what is it about referendums that make them so difficult to pass?
The double majority is the big one. The double majority means that you have to convince a huge base of the Australian people that this change is important. The majority of people in a majority of states have to vote to change the constitution in order for the referendum to pass.
What role do you think social media plays in a successful referendum?
The last time there was a referendum was 1999, and I'm pretty sure there was no social media back in 1999.
I had a Nokia.
We were all playing Snake. That's rather right. than getting on social media. So it's hard for us to judge based on history as to how social media might affect this campaign.
Well, thank you so much, Amy, for taking me through this incredible exhibition. I know I feel very much more informed.
Thank you for coming, and I'll see you in the line for a democracy sausage.